If you're making some utility app in Unity and need access to system files and folders, then here's how this shit's done. Go to the GitHub link in description, this guy made a wrapper that does everything for you. So make sure to leave him a star on that GitHub project. Anyway, download the package, open up your project in Unity, and open the package to import it straight to your folders. Create a sample script or use one of your existing ones. To load a file, or a couple of them, you can do a few things. Firstly, you can load it in the same thread, which is the simplest. Add using SFB directive, it stands for Unity Standalone File Browser, and define extension filter set. Those extensions will define what options we are given in the File Explorer dialog. In each extension filter, you can define the name that will show up, as well as data extensions, what file format is after the dot. For example, .dat, .txt, .playerdata. After that, we're gonna define a select file function that will open the file browser. We use a method called openFilePanel. This method takes a few arguments. First is the name of the File Explorer window that will pop up. Then there is current directory. Then we pass on the extensions that we created. And lastly, we pass in the bool that will define whether we want a couple of files to be selectable or just one. Let's print out the result, which is the path to the selected file. If we selected multiple files, the whole array would be filled. Please ignore the errors. It's Unity being shit as usual on new projects. In this case, it cannot load some plastic bullshit. As you can see, File Explorer window pops up correctly. We can specify the file types that we defined earlier, and we can open the file. The file path displays correctly. You may notice that I added a script that moves the camera, and the script wasn't active when the file browser window was open. That is because the behavior of the script was synchronous. That means it blocked the main thread. To fix this, we can use another approach. We're gonna add a thread that will handle the situation. Add using system.threading, and then specify a new thread. Start the thread with the method that we created. Lastly, you can join the thread back to the main one. As you can see, now when we run the application, the browser window pops up, but also the app works in the background. You can also modify the window to display save file option instead of loading file by just changing the method name and some arguments. To handle files that you obtain with the file path, you can use some generic C# methods, like file stream based on file.open method. This plugin is supposed to be cross-platform, but there are some limitations, so make sure to read into the repository itself. That's it, see ya!